Alright, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a next button. That's what I'm going to call it at least. Touching this arrow right here, I can see the forecast now. Let me back up a little bit. Okay, like today is Saturday, November 7th, so this is tomorrow, and if I tap this, it's going to go to Monday, then Tuesday. Notice the dates are changing and the maxes and the mins are changing. And the cool thing about this is that it's very minimal. It's taking up a minimum amount of space on our root folder. Nothing's truly animating here. We're just kind of like toggling through some days. And what I have it doing is this is next Saturday, 11:14. And then when I go to my next one there, it's going to show me tomorrow. So really I'm advancing over the next 7 days. And we can go backwards as well. Now this is my newest update for Dark Skittles as well. This is the same setup, but you know, down here I can change my colors with the particular pieces in here, but this works the same way. So little color buttons, changing whatever colors we see there. But I want to show you how to advance a day, so to speak. Let's go into KOWP. And I'm going to be using actually my cell phone some too, so you might not see this mouse move as much. But scrolling, I'm going to start from a blank slate. And right off the bat, I'm going to go ahead and create a global variable, and I'm going to do a text global, and I'm going to call it n for number. Make it short and sweet, and I'll just give it a value of 1. We might come back and change this in a minute. Now here's an issue I was having with this. I'm going to add a text item. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. And let's change the text. Let's look at the day of the week, kind of like what you saw at the beginning of the video. And what we're focusing on is this A1D that you see in that code right there, A1D. Now here's what I was trying to do at first, and this was not working. If I came into here and I changed this to, like, I was trying to do GVN. Now remember that global variable I just created a moment ago? The GVN had a number. And I think the number we put in there was 1. Well, notice it's telling me I have a problem. So I was sitting here messing around, and I was just trying to say, okay, maybe I had too many parentheses. So I was doing GVN like that, and it still tells me I have a problem. Basically, I want this thing A1D, A2D, A3D. Notice if I delete all this stuff, if I put like 1, tomorrow's Sunday, 2 days would be Monday, 3 days would be Tuesday. So notice it is changing, but I want this to change on the fly. So here's what I figured out. Here's how we can fix this. I'm going to just go ahead and check that for right now. I'm going to come back and I'm going to add another global variable. I'm going to create another text. And notice it was A1D, A2D, A3D. I'm just going to call this D, text global variable. And I'm going to use this global variable inside of this one. So inside of this one, D, I'm going to call this A. And then I need a code GVN. And then I'm going to put a D. Check that out. A1D. So whatever my global variable N, that first one I created, if it's a, well, it must be a 1 because it's AD and then there's a 1 in between it, as you can see in the preview. Let me save that. And now, for example, if I come in here and change this to a that number right there, 3,423, okay? I changed N to that crazy number. Well, let me come down here to this global variable D, and it's going to say A, 3,423. So these two global variables are working together. And again, whatever, get out of the way, whatever I have right here in N, if I change that to 34, notice if I come down here to my text global variable D, it's going to show 34, A34D. So this right here is what we're going to use in our date. It's going to look 34 days ahead. Now, I don't want to look that far ahead, so how can I fix that? I want to change this back to a 1. All right. So this says A1D. Now, let's revisit that text item. Alright, I want to delete all of this. Now notice if I type in A1D, it's going to say Sunday. Alright, but I want this to change. So what I need to do in this A1D part, I need to use that global variable D that I just created. So I'm going to do global variable D, and I'm going to close it up. So Saturday, EEGVD, did I change that back to a zero? Let me check this. Today is Saturday. Let me go to my globals. I have this on one, A1D, and it's GVD. I don't know why that's not working right. Let me see what we got here. GVD. I bet if I save this and actually look at it, it's working right. As you can see, it is showing it there. I don't know why. You know, sometimes that what you see, what you get for KOWP doesn't work exactly as it should. So, but yeah, it's working like it should. I don't know why it's saying Saturday there. I mean, it should say Sunday. As you can see, it just did say Sunday. Nonetheless, we're going to go ahead and, I tell you what, for reference, I'm going to come back and I'm going to do another text. I'm going to put this one at the bottom just for reference. I like to do that to kind of show you as I teach you these things too. So I'm going to go to bottom. And just for this text item, what I want to do is I just want to see what the value of GVD is. So GVD, I just want to see what the value of it is as we change some things. Of course, it's going to say that, isn't it? Yep. Okay, well, let me do another text item too then. All right. Coming back here. I'm just going to add one more piece of text. And I'm going to do GVN. Just as a reference. So let me move that down to the bottom as well. And just bump it up a little bit. Oops, wrong way. All right, so we're seeing how these things are kind of working together. A1D, because this is what the value of GVN is actually right now. So A1D is what's supposed to make this say Sunday. And again, if I save this, I go back to my home screen and it is showing Sunday. So A1D, look, I don't need that one. See how that's showing up different versus what it does inside of the editor? It's driving me nuts, but it is what it is. So I don't even need that text item there. I thought it should be showing a one instead of the GVN thing. So deleting that, we'll see this on the home screen. All right, so back in here, let's add another piece of text. Now, what you should be doing is we should be putting these things inside of like a stack group or something like that. I'm just going to do that real quick. I'm going to cut, and I'm going to paste it right inside of a stack group. So now let's do another piece of text for the date. So I'm just going to copy and paste that. And for this one, I want to see what the date's going to be. So all I need to do here is I'm actually come in here and change this to month and day with padding. There we go. So now it's going to show the month and the day for whatever GVD is. And since GVD is A1D, it's going to be showing what tomorrow's date is. It should be doing this correctly. I'll tell you what, little OCD, I'm going to vertically center this stat group. And if I save this, go back to the home screen, Sunday 11/8, and that is correct. Tomorrow will be the 8th of November. Again, A1D. Now let's start seeing this stuff change. What do you say? All right, so two quick buttons. I'm just going to go back to root. I'm going to add a shape. I'm going to do a whatever. I'll leave it as a square. Let me position this in the right center. I'm just going to make it a touch bigger. And I want this little square here to serve as an advance. I want to advance this A1D. I want it to become A1D, A2D, A3D. And let's just make it go up for, I don't know, the next 10 days or whatever. So touching this square, what we want to do is I want to do a toggle global switch. And now I don't want to toggle D. I want to toggle N. Remember, and you can see it right here. Look right there. A-G-V-N-D. I just want to change this G-V-N. I want to change it from a 1 to a 2 to a 3 to a 4, etc. So I want to toggle the N, and I'm going to say this. Let's do it for the next 7 days. So, and actually I'll show today's date as well. So if GVN, if it is, we want to advance, so if it is less than 7, I want to see the next 7 days, then what I want to do, so any number, if this number N right now is 1, if it's less than 7, I want to add 1 to it. So the way we do that is we do GVN, whatever value it is, and then we're going to add 1 to it. So for example, right now, GVN is 1, so it is less than 7. So it's going to take it and it's going to add 1 to it. Now suppose it is not less than 7. Suppose that we hit 7, what do we want to do? I want to go back to 0. I'll show you why. 0 is going to actually end up matching with today's date, and you'll see that in a few minutes. But there's our code. So remember how N was 1? It's already added 1 more to it to make it 2. And this button will automatically change this as we do it. But I tell you what, let's go ahead and add another button. Let's take this, copy, paste. I'm just pasting that button, but now this new button, I'm going to do it on the center left, not bottom left. And I want to change its touch to this. So here, I want to go backwards. So I got to change a few things in my code. GVN is greater than 0. So any number that's greater than 0, I want to take it and go backwards. So that means we want to subtract 1 from the global variable N. And then what if it's not? Whoops, what if it's not greater than 0? What if it is 0? I want to go back to 7. And these are the buttons that we have. So I'm going to explain this as I actually touch the buttons. This should be right. Let me check that. And let's back up and let's save. All right, so going to the home screen. Right now we're on A1D. That's tomorrow's date. Tomorrow's Sunday, November 8th. So if I press this, it should go to A2D, which is 2 days away. Check it out. Monday, November 9th. A3D, Tuesday, November 10th. Watch this. A4D. Seeing it change? And seeing it change up here? Now remember, we went up to 7. Every time this code over here for touch, it says if that value of N is less than 7, which it is, we want to add 1 to it. So watch, when I touch it, it's adding 1 to it. Whoops. If I touch it, it's adding 1 to it. If I touch it, it's adding 1 to it. And all this stuff up here is changing. Oh, Friday the 13th is next week. Uh-oh. And then now it's still less than 7, so it's going to add 1 to it. Now, the value of N down here is no longer less than 7. It's equal to 7. So this is where that other part comes into play. I want this to go back to 0. That's what my code was for this touch. If it wasn't less than 7, I want to go back to 0. So watch this. Boom. A0. And that's today's date. A0D, think of it as 0 days away. That's right now. So again, touching these, I'm going to come over here to my phone and do it. But I'm touching, and as you can see, it is going 5, 6, 7, back to 0. Now let's go over here and touch this one. It's going to go backwards because this code says, here, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And this code says that if our number is, for example, 6, if this number is bigger than 0, which it is, and that number right there is bigger than 0, we want to subtract 1 from it. So by touching, it's subtracting 1. Our dates are going backwards, which is what it should be doing. And then when it's not less than 0, right here, when it's not less than 0 because it is equal to 0, we want to go back to 7. And as you can see, it's doing exactly that when we touch it. But here's the nice thing about this, again, too. It's truly not animating. It's more of a toggle. So what I've done now, as I've gone back and I've cleaned everything up. Again, this is not the most visually appealing thing, but since we're not animating anything here, we're just toggling. All of this stuff can be housed inside of one little piece inside of your root, since we're not truly animating anything. So this saves you some space in your root folder, because remember, you can only have a certain number of pieces, a number of items in your root folder before it becomes full. So all of this stuff, my text, my buttons, I've just put them all inside of one little stack group. Of course, I have stack groups inside of stack groups, but my point is we're not taking up a lot of space. But there you have it. That is how you can use a next button to cycle through dates and using minimum space inside of your root folder. And that is it for this video. Hope it helped.